वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन मोर प्रेजेंट हियर। सो बेसिकली आई वुड लाइक टू कीप दिस सेशन एज शॉर्ट एंड स्वीट एज पॉसिबल। सो वी आर गोइंग टू बेसिकली सी व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज ऐप बिल्डिंग, हाउ वी कैन क्रिएट एन ऐप दैट टू विदाउट अ सिंगल पीस ऑफ कोडिंग। सो आई होप यू आर क्लियर विद व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दिस वर्कशॉप इज ऑल अबाउट। सो बेसिकली वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न व्हाट आर द वेरियस थिंग्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर क्रिएटिंग एन ऐप and that too without coding. Fine, so let me quickly give you a brief walkthrough of the various apps that I have created in the last 3 to 4 days, and trust me, they are very simple to create. You don't need any IT comms background to create any app. They are very simple to create. You simply need to go through few steps, and I will I'm expecting you all to create an app in this session itself. So whenever you're going to fill the feedback for this session, I would expect you all to paste the URL of the app that you have created during this session itself. So let me quickly give you a walkthrough of the various apps that you can create, the various type of apps, and what are the various requirements. So first of all, you can see this is an app that I had created 3 days back, if I'm not wrong. This is basically a lecture recording, a lecture monitoring app, or you can say lecture tracking app, where you can upload your lectures, day-to-day lectures that you have created with your students. Obviously, we know that there are various options available. There are options such as Google Classroom, which is already a very beautiful application. But there are some things which even Google has. For example, you need to create folders and then segregate your videos accordingly, your notes, your lecture videos, your short notes, etc. So what you can do is you can have your own customized application, which you can then share with your students. So this is basically a customized application that I had created. Over here, you can segregate it into multiple videos, notes, short videos, or any demo videos that you had created for your students. You can share it directly with your students. So what it will do is you will basically have a portable sort of a classroom where the students can access any of your videos on the go. At the end, I will show you the demo of this. This is just the introduction of the various apps that you can create using this platform. Fine. Next app is this one. This is again a very important app from us teachers' point of view. What we do is at the end of every month, we start gathering the data for our newsletter, right? So you all know that gathering data for a newsletter could be a tedious task. Why tedious? Because there is always always a risk of inconsistency. You might end up missing some data for a particular edition. How it happens? Because as you know, there are multiple faculties or students working on that particular newsletter team. What happens is if I have conducted a seminar or webinar like we are doing right now, we create the reports for them and share it with the respective faculty members. There might be a possibility that you end up forgetting or end up sending the data for that particular event, or you might end up sending to one of those faculty members and others might not get the data. So there is always a risk of inconsistency involved. So in such a case, you can have an application like this. You can see on your screen, this is a newsletter app. Over here, one section will be for all the newsletter editions, and the other section could be for gathering the data. Now you can share this sort of an app with your faculty members or with your students. They can upload the contents, they can upload articles, etc. So at the end, you will get a systemized, you can say, spreadsheet where every data will be present at a single point of location, point of entry, right? So this is one of the apps. Next one is this one. This is a book sharing app. This was actually the very first app that I had created while learning this particular technology. So what you can do is instead of novels, comics, you can add your notes. You can segregate your notes lecture wise. For example, over here, as you can see, I have taken inspiration from Harry Potter series. So instead of that, you can use your own chapter wise notes, chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, and then share it with your students. The students can go through it. They can ask questions if needed. They can give their comments, feedback, everything. And each and every viewer or each and every participant of that particular app will get access to all the comments. They can even add their own comment. They can even share this with their friends from different colleges, etc. So the final app is this one, a very simple app. This is what you are going to use at the end of today's session. So depending upon how this session goes, you can add your feedback. And at the end, I'm also expecting the URL of the app that you are going to create from this session, in this session basically. Fine, so let me quickly go back to the actual demo and then we will start building our first app. Let me share my entire screen. I hope it is visible.
Yes, sir, visible.
Yes.
Fine, thank you. Thanks a lot. So this is a quick demo of the lecture app. This is what we are going to design today in today's session. It's hardly going to be 40-45 minute session based upon how quickly we grasp. So just a quick demo. As you can see over here, this particular app consists of only two sections or two tabs. On the left hand side, the lecture videos are present. I have sorted them according to the lectures I have conducted. I guess for 25 to 26 lectures are there. And on the right hand side, there is one more section for short videos. So what you can do, entirely depends on you. You can entirely customize it according to your wish, according to your subject. If you have short videos, you can add them. If you have some other videos from YouTube which you find very useful, or from the student's point of view, you can add them. So let me quickly show you what exactly is this app all about. Let me go into any of these videos. So once I go into the lecture video, you can see I have directly embedded YouTube video over here. If you are having a YouTube channel, you can add your YouTube videos. Or if you have uploaded the Google Drive recording, that also you can add over here. So what we need is, we simply need the link for that video lecture of yours. If you have notes for that particular lecture, you can add those notes over here. And you are also giving some option for the students to leave a comment. In case a student doesn't understand what exactly this topic is all about, you can then ask the students to leave a comment or a feedback. They can obviously use it. Fine. And then if the student wants to directly go to YouTube, you can also always put the YouTube link over here for this particular video. But what that will do is, the user will then leave your app and then go to YouTube directly. So to avoid that, you can simply embed the video link over here, here only. So if I click this, you can see that the video starts playing over here. And you can obviously go to full screen, you can exit the full screen. So it's a very customizable app that you can create within few minutes. That's the name of the session, create an app in a snap. Right, so that is the main thing. You can go over here, you can give the option of downloading the note. It will directly go to your drive folder. You can link it with your drive. Students will be able to download the notes. Fine, so this is the app that we are going to create. So let me go back to this section and I will show you what are the various steps that are needed. Fine, so is it clear so far? Kindly let me know whenever if I am going fast, I can slow it down for you.
So clear, sir.
Okay, thanks a lot. So the very first step is create a data structure. So obviously people from comms IT background have a knowledge about it. So let me keep it in a very simple terms, in a simple layman term. What exactly is a data structure? So for creating any app, the very first thing you need is the database or data structure. The way you accept the data, the way you store the data. In simple terms, we can call it as a data structure. So as you know, app creation is a very tedious task. In general terms, app creation is a very difficult task because you need to have knowledge about Android Studio, Java, etc., etc. But in this case, we are not going to focus on technicalities. We are not going to see how Java could be used to create an app. We are not going into that much detail. We want to keep it as simple as possible so that even a child can create an app. Like we know, there are various ads where they show that a child has created an app. So consider that we are children over here. We are learning some new things. So we are going to create an app from scratch without any single piece of coding. So the data structure that we are going to require over here is nothing but a simple Google spreadsheet. Fine. So the only prerequisite is having a Google account, which we already have. Fine. So the very first step is create a data structure. So I would request you all to kindly log into your Google accounts, open Google Sheets. So you can simply go to your drive or you can simply go to sheets.google.com and create a blank spreadsheet. Kindly let me know if you are following this, and whenever you I speed up, kindly let me know. Fine.
Done, sir.
Okay, thanks. So the very first step is you need to give some headings. So as you can see in this application, whenever you're uploading any video, it should have some headings or it should have some, what you can say, columns, right? So let me quickly show you You can see this. These are the columns that you are going to need. So kindly create these many columns over there. These are nothing but the headers. Okay. So the first column is topic, second is module. You can obviously change it accordingly, but for this session, I'm going to stick with it. You can later on change them accordingly. Topic, module, lecture, cover. Cover is nothing but an image. So instead of cover, you can also write image if you want. The link of that video. There should be some sharing options, and there could be some list add options. I will talk about sharing and list add whenever I reach that particular point. For the time being, kindly add these as the headings. Let me copy these. Let me write it somewhere over here, and I will copy it down. Yeah, they are not case sensitive. You can write it in any way you wish. So basically, if you can see, the headings are topic, module, lecture, cover, link, sharing, and list add. Fine. One of the tricks I found out recently is if you want to freeze these columns or freeze these rows, what you can do is simply go over here and drag it like this. I didn't know about it, so I learned about it and wanted to share it with you. So now you can see that it gets freezed automatically. I didn't know about it actually. So these are the various columns that we want: topic, module, lecture, cover, link, sharing, and list add. Now next, what we need to do is simply go to this website, glideapps.com, and log in using the same Google account from which you have created your spreadsheet. glideapps.com. Let me put it in the chat box. And you visit this website, glideapps.com, and log in using your Google ID, the same ID from which you have created the spreadsheet, Google spreadsheet. Kindly let me know once done.
Yes, sir, it is done. Now we need to allow the access.
Yes, ma'am, you need to allow the access.
Okay.
Because it will access your Google account for the spreadsheet, so it will automatically link it with an app. So after logging in, this is how your interface should look like. So I will pause it over here. Kindly, everyone should come at the same page, then I will start resuming it with you.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
Done, sir. Okay. What about others? Kindly let me know. You should come to this page. Obviously,
yes,
it will be
done, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you. So after you have reached this particular step, after you have reached this particular step, click on New App. And before that, one small step, kindly give a name to your spreadsheet. For example, I'm giving it demo. You should reach this particular step. After clicking on new app, you should reach this step. Select a source. Yeah. So are we here at the same page?
Yes.
Can we?
Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. So now click on Google Sheets and click continue. From here, you can select the app that you have, select the Google Sheet that you have just now created. That is the, in my case, it is demo. Select that and click select. As the heading of this particular workshop is all about, it is creating an app in a snap, and you will see that your app is created. Obviously, it is created, but it still needs a lot of customization. You need to add data to it, right? So kindly let me know if you all have reached this particular page. There are new items.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir.
Thanks a lot. So what you need to do is now you need to start populating your Excel sheet. That is our step number 7, step number 8, because ultimately what we have done so far is we have already covered step number 1 to 7. As you can see, create the data structure, log into this particular site, use the same Google account, click on new app, click on Google Sheet, then select the Google Sheet you have just now created. The fields should automatically populate it. Now what you need to do is, in our case, we don't have any data on our Google Sheet, so you need to add data in your Google Sheet. So what I would expect you to do is, you can start adding at least 2 or 3 lectures over here. If you have access to your recordings, kindly add those topic wise, or you can even start with some dummy data. It won't harm us. So what you can do is, you can give some name to the topics. You can start with the module, the lecture, cover. Let me give you an example. Let me show you this particular Google Sheet. As you can see, this is visible, right? Or shall I increase the font? I guess this is visible now. So what you can do is, you can add it like this. Topic, module, lecture. I'll talk about the cover thing later. At least start with this. At least add 2 or 3 topics. If you have real data, you can add it. Otherwise, you can add some dummy data. Kindly let me know if it is clear so far. Yes, kindly let me know if you have added at least 2 to 3 rows of data. I will talk about this sharing and list add column, but at least
sir,
kindly
sir,
add.
Wait.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, wait for 1 minute.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. This is just for reference. You can start adding accordingly. Only leave the cover, sharing, and list add columns blank. Kindly start filling the rest of the columns. I will just show you what exactly is cover, sharing, and list add. At least 2 to 3 rows, you can fill it up. Just make sure the link is proper. It can be any YouTube video, it can be your Google Drive recording. Anything will do. Done? Fine. Kindly let me know if everyone has done it, so that I can move ahead. Done? Okay, what about, okay. Sampada ma'am, Swapnali ma'am, Jigar sir, done?
Done, sir.
Yes, done, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. So next, what we need to do is, let me talk about this cover and list add. So what exactly happens is, cover is nothing but, as you can see, if I point my mouse over there, it is nothing but an image. In YouTube, we see see that every video is having a thumbnail. So it is basically like a thumbnail. So what you can do is, right now, if due to time constraints, we can't start creating the thumbnails from scratch. What you can do is, you can simply go to Paint and create a dummy sort of template or dummy sort of thumbnail right now. So you can simply go to Paint and you can write anything you wish, and that would be treated as your cover image for your video. So you can simply add some data, whatever you want, dummy video, lecture, or whatever it may be. And then add it as an image, save it as an image. Dummy lecture or dummy video, whatever you want to call it. Fine. I'm not focusing on the symmetry aspect. Simply save it as an image. It could be JPEG, it could be BMP, whatever you wish. And let me save it on desktop. Fine. Once done, kindly acknowledge.
Done, sir.
Thanks a lot. So next step, what you need to do is the image that you have just now created. One second. The image that you have just now created over here, in my case, this is the image. You can simply upload it on your Google Drive. Just make sure the Google Drive should be the same, linked with the same Google account. Fine. So let me go to my Drive. This is my Google Drive. So I will upload the image over here. I'm using the personal ID. You can use any Google account you wish. So once the image is uploaded, simply go to share and just make sure that it is public. Anyone with the link. It should not be restricted. The same applies with your Google Drive links, Google Drive recordings. If you want this app to be used by the students, then you need to make sure that the video recordings that you are putting in the app, they should be unrestricted, or it should be shared with anyone with the link, right? Simply copy it, go to your Excel sheet and paste it in cover. I will again repeat the step. What you need to do is the image that you have just now created, you need to upload it on your Google Drive. Fine. Kindly let me know if I'm going fast. Upload it on your Google Drive. Then go to the sharing options. Fine. And just make sure that it is accessible by anyone publicly. So when you reach the sharing option, click on this anyone on the internet with the link. Copy the link. You can keep the access rights as viewer only, because you don't need the users to edit it, right? You don't want them to edit it. So you can keep it viewer only. Copy the link and then go back to the Excel sheet that you have just now created. In my case, it is this one, demo, and paste it in the cover section. Fine. Now let me give some topic title over here, sample introduction. Module could be module number one, lecture number one, and now link. So for link, you can add any of your Google recordings, any of your lecture recording drive links. Fine. So I expect kindly populate 2 to 3 rows, and then we can resume it. Kindly do it in the meantime. I will also do it. I will just pick any of the videos from my YouTube channel and paste it over here. Copy link address, go to this and paste it. Fine. So if we have reached this, kindly let me know once you have completed 2 to 3 rows. Fine. I'm not able to access the chat.
Sir, wait for some time.
Yeah, I'm waiting. I'm not able to access the chat, so kindly let me know whenever I'm going fast. What you can do is, just for this dummy section, you can simply copy the cover image. As you have not got time to create your dummy images for each and every lecture, you can simply copy the same link in the next 2-3 rows. That will do. Just to save time. Fine. So I'm adding some more goes over here. And then I'm even copying the lecture video also. In your case, if you're having the actual data, you can use it. My case, just to keep things simple, I'm copying the same data here also. Fine. So kindly let me know if you have reached till here.
Yes, sir.
What about others? Nikhil, sir? Nikhil, sir, Deepak, sir, Kaveri, ma'am?
Done, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
सर बस एक मिनट।
यस यस सर, यस सर, आराम से। In the meantime, what you can do is simply start writing false over here in list add. This is basically a boolean value, true and false. We will come to know later when we actually start designing the GUI. For the time being, kindly write false in all of these rows in list add. Fine, so can I move ahead? Kindly acknowledge.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Okay. So the next step is, what is the sharing part? Okay. You saw in this app, right? That when I go to this particular, any of the particular videos, I have the option of sharing this lecture, right? So whenever you share this, you will get something like this as a prompt. So you might have experienced in various apps that whenever we want to share some element or share some item with our friends, there are options of sharing on email, sharing by WhatsApp, right? So this is nothing but that feature only. So what you can do is you can write something, for example, as you can see, hello friend, I'm sharing with you the lecture video on the topic. So what happens is the only coding part on what you can see or what you can say, something distantly related to coding is nothing but over here, a formula. Simple formula, Excel formula. I will just share it with you. I will just copy it in your chat box. This is the only coding part you can say. Otherwise, nothing is involved over here. You can change it accordingly. I have shared it in the chat box. Kindly copy that and paste it in your sharing ka column. Fine. Just cross-check whether the output is coming properly or not, like this, and I will explain this formula, don't worry. This is very simple. What we are doing is, if you check this formula, it is nothing but array formula. If A2 to A, A2 is nothing but this column, and I'm starting with A2, that is second row, right? So I'm starting from the second row till the entire A column. Jitne bhi values A ke column mein honge, wo sab ke sab wahan pe cover honge. And I'm writing it like this. Hello friend, I'm sharing with you the lecture video on the topic. Now the topic is dynamic. It depends upon the row number. So it is basically A2. In the next section, you will see it is already populated. So once I start entering the formula in the first column, first row, everything else will automatically be filled. Let me delete it. And if I paste it again, one second, just let me copy that. Actually, I deleted it without copying it. Let me copy that. But paste it over here. Automatically, each and every row is populated. Fine? Is it clear so far?
Yes,
so
sir.
As you can see, whenever we are moving row by row, it is automatically getting populated with that particular value. So if I copy the same thing in this particular section, it should be populated. Fine, let me word wrap it. X wrap, yeah. Fine, so you can do the modifications accordingly. Everything which you see in green color, that you can change accordingly. It depends on you, right? Fine, so I hope this particular data structure is ready by now. If anyone is having any issues, kindly let me know.
No issue, sir.
मैम व्हाट इज द इशू स्वप्नली मैम जस्ट काइंडली मेक श्योर दैट योर एक्सेल शीट इज एग्जैक्टली सिमिलर टू दिस
Yes, sir, it is, but it is showing hashtag reference exclamation.
Ma'am, kindly check it whether it is exactly, the code is exactly same or not. Because agar aap pura copy paste karoge to hona chahiye work. Ek baar dekh lo. Aur columns bhi ek baar dekh lo. A2 to A hai ki nahi. Column ka naam change hoga to wahan pe aapko accordingly change karna padega. Kuch brackets ka issue hoga. Shayad closing bracket ek kam liya rahega. What about others? Kindly let me know.
Working fine, sir.
Okay. Can I move ahead?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thank you. So let's get back to the actual app. Okay. So now if you go back to your app page, it should automatically be updated. Kindly check and let me know if it is updated or not.
Updated.
Okay, updated, right? Now we are going to start making changes to it. Yes, it is updated. Fine. So now, as you can see on top, there are three options. The first one is your data structure. So if you click on it, this one, this is nothing but your Excel sheet. So it gets automatically added, linked with it. And on its side, left side, you can see a refresh button. So whenever you make some changes to your Excel sheet, don't forget to refresh it, refresh this so that it gets automatically updated for the next time. Fine. So if I do some change, I need to come back to this front end and do the refresh altogether from here. Fine. So now if you compare it with this app, this is slightly different. How come? Let me show it to you. We need to do some changes and at the end, we will get our app looking like this. Fine. So what we need to do is, let me quickly get back. This is my previous app. And this is the app we are working on. This is the app we are working on. So what you can do is on the right hand side, you can see there are some options of styling. So if you click on tiles, it will look something like this. If you click on checklist, it will look something like this. So ultimately, as mentioned over here, give wings to your creativity and explore the dashboard to modify the app accordingly. But ultimately depends on you. How you want your app to look like. So finally, if you see this looks better, according to this, if I want to make an exact copy of this, I have used cards. So you can use card, swipe, details, whatever you wish. Details will look like this. Swipe will look like this. So ultimately, whichever looks better, stick with it. In my case, I found out this cards layout looks better. So I stuck with the cards layout. Fine. Is everyone following it? Kindly let me know.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thanks a lot. So start experimenting with it. You can add any image of your choice. Start experimenting with the styling. And at the end, I will show you how to change the colors and all. Fine. So if you click on this, it will look something like this, but it looks very boring. Right. So we need to start making changes. It should look like this. And for that, we need to do some changes. Fine. At the bottom, we are having two options, play mode and select mode. When you click on play mode, it is like you are actually interacting with the app. When I click on this, you will actually go inside that particular tab. But in the case of select mode, you can do modifications to each of these tabs. As you can see, if I scroll my mouse, if I hover my mouse, I can actually select that section over here. This is nothing but a section, a text. This is automatically populated from the Excel sheet that we had created. If you want to change it, you can simply change it from here. Right. These are the things that you can do. In my case, as you can see, if I click on this, this is nothing but a video. So how to add a video? It's very simple. What you can do is click on this plus button over here. First of all, let me know if everyone is on the same page so that we can start doing this customization.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thanks a lot. So click on this button, plus button over here. And you will see something like this video, blue button, embed video from YouTube, Vimeo, etc. So click on that. And as you can see at the bottom, the video is automatically added. Why? Because we had already given an option in the sheet as link. So that link gets automatically added. If not, then what you can do is you can select this. First of all, you can select this and then you can drag it. Kindly let me know if the video is added or not. From the right hand side, you can select the link for the video. So what you can do is simply select the column which corresponds to this video. I guess in your case, the column corresponds to the link tab. So assign it with the link tab and you should automatically see the video. Kindly let me know if I am going fast. Kindly let me know. Kindly acknowledge. The video should be visible. If you are not able to see the video, kindly check which column it is binded with. You can simply select this. Just make sure you are inside the select mode. In the play mode, it will not work. Just make sure about it. Kindly acknowledge and let me know.
Sir, we have
sir,
to select
please
link
repeat.
In tile, right?
What, sir?
We have to select link in tile.
Yes, sir. In the video section, you have to select this link because that corresponds to the video recording. Yes, sir. Very
sir, can you please repeat?
Yes, ma'am. Which step?
Screen adding.
Okay, ma'am. वापस से करके देता हूँ. So this is what you will see initially, right? ठीक है. I'm again repeating the step. What you need to do is click on this add button over here and click on video. Aisa kuch to aayega by default.
Sir, the add button is not
add button disabled. Haan, mera bhi same sir. Add button disabled hai. Screen ke
add button disabled hai. Ma'am, select mode pe ho ki play mode pe ho? Ek baar dekho, check karo.
How to select the select mode?
Ma'am, first of all, you need to go inside the sheet. One second. Yeah, there's all. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I will just show it once again. This is how your main interface will look like. Fine. Yahan pe sabko same dikh raha hai ki kuch different hai kisi ke case mein? Kindly let me know.
Yes,
same,
sir. Same hai na? Okay. So now go inside one of these videos. Agar mere case mein 4-5 dale hai maine. So वो ऐसा डिस्प्ले हो रहा है. मेक श्योर इट इज कार्ड्स. आप कुछ भी सेलेक्ट कर सकते हो, इससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता. इट विल लुक लाइक दिस इन केस ऑफ लिस्ट. कार्ड्स होगा तो ऐसा दिखेगा.
ओके ओके सर, नाउ गॉट इट.
या फाइन. सो गेट इनसाइड वन ऑफ दीज वीडियोस, देन यू विल बी एबल टू एड इट. आई होप अभी क्लियर है सबको. एनीवन देयर काइंडली लेट मी नो हु हैज नॉट येट. क्लियर सर?
क्लियर सर.
ओके, थैंक्स अ लॉट. So this is how you need to add. मैं वापस एक बार delete करके दिखाता हूँ चाहिए तो. What you need to do is this plus button should be active now. Click on plus, click on video. Because of time constraints, I'm not able to show each and everything. Because अब यहाँ पे देखोगे तो यहाँ पे बहुत सारे options हैं. You can add reactions, you can add choice, event pickers, email, n number of things are there. But to keep it short, I'm simply sticking to this video. Right now you can change the order. ऊपर नीचे करके आप उसको ऑर्डर कर सकते हो. जस्ट मेक श्योर कि इट इज लिंक्ड विद द एक्चुअल कॉलम. बाय डिफॉल्ट यहाँ पे कवर से लिंक है. यू कैन चेंज इट टू द एक्चुअल लिंक फ्रॉम योर एक्सेल शीट. इफ यू हैव गिवन अ प्रॉपर लिंक, इट शुड बी विजिबल. मतलब जो भी आपने लिंक डाला होगा वो विजिबल होना चाहिए. काइंडली लेट मी नो इफ इट इज डन.
वर्किंग सर, वर्किंग.
यस सर.
ओके, थैंक्स अ लॉट. Jigar sir, done?
Working sir.
Thank you sir. Now we need to do some changes accordingly. As you can see, first one is introduction, so it is in proper place. Then module 1, so we need to do some changes. You can now click on any of these tabs. Just make sure you are in select mode. And when you click on it, you will get options on the right hand side. What you can do is just make sure it is properly linked. Now as you know, the sheet is this. Introduction is linked with topic, right? So what you can do is you simply need to do the changes accordingly. If I click on this introduction, it should be linked with topic. Just make sure it is correct. Fine. and just change it to topic. What you can do is, as you can see, it is repeated. So you can omit one of these things. अगर दो दो बार हम लोग यहाँ पे टॉपिक से लिंक करेंगे व्हाट विल हैपन वो दो दो बार दिखेगा यहाँ पे आपको दिख रहा होगा इंट्रोडक्शन इज द हेडिंग एंड इट इज ऑल्सो रिफ्लेक्टेड ट्वाइस सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज जो डिटेल्स वाला टैब है यू कैन सेलेक्ट दैट एंड क्लिक ऑन कस्टम टू कीप इट ब्लैंक यहाँ तक हुआ सबका काइंडली लेट मी नो
सर इफ यू क्लिक ऑन द ऑप्शन there is something visibility दिखा रहा है to enable visibility condition you must have user profile configured
नहीं मैम वो ऑप्शंस नहीं ऑप्शंस पे मत जाओ जनरल पे रहो
जनरल पे ओके जनरल पे फिर टैब्स लेबल
जनरल में हां डिटेल्स वाला ब्लैंक कर दो डिटेल्स को कस्टम कर दो
ओके
मैं दिखाता हूं ये देखो डिटेल्स में जाओ एंटर डिटेल्स जो है वहां पे आपको शायद ये मॉड्यूल या टॉपिक करके कुछ लिख के आ रहेगा जस्ट चेंज इट टू कस्टम
ओके
एनीवन एल्स फेसिंग द सेम इशू काइंडली लेट मी नो
नो सर
यस
थैंक यू मैम इन द सेम वे बाकी सबको आपको चेंज करना है वॉट एवर यू विश यू कैन एड इट फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई डोंट वॉन्ट दिस कवर कवर की जरूरत नहीं है कवर कहाँ पे जरूरत है कवर यहाँ पे जरूरत है राइट सो वॉट आई कैन डू इज वॉट एवर थिंग्स आई डोंट वॉन्ट आई कैन सिंपली गो ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड एंड डिलीट इट सो आई डोंट वॉन्ट कवर सो आई डिलीटेड इट फाइन To compare it with this app, it looks very decent, but over here it looks a lot boring. So what you can do is click on this sharing. Instead of giving this text, if you see over here, instead of giving the entire text, I'm simply linking it with topic. Fine. And instead of this topic, I can write anything. For example, share my lecture or share this lecture. Whatever you want to write on top of the heading, you can. Write it in title and while sharing for example jab main yahan pe share kar raha hu let me show it if I'm sharing it yahan pe likh ke aata hai introduction fine mobile pe dikhega yahan pe properly nahi dikhega so when you share it wahan pe topic ka naam likh ke aata hai that is enough I guess instead of writing the entire thing instead of writing this hello friend I'm sharing with you so and so the introduction itself is enough fine am I clear यहाँ तक हुआ सबका
डन
फाइन
डन
ओके थैंक्स अ लॉट नाउ वन थिंग रिमेनिंग इज इफ यू सी देयर इज वन बटन ओवर हियर राइट सो इफ इफ आई वांट दिस बटन ओवर हियर व्हाट आई नीड टू डू इज आई नीड टू ऐड सम एक्शन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर टैब सो फॉर दैट ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड यू कैन सी ऑप्शन सच एज एक्शन सो क्लिक ऑन एक्शन एंड There should be an option, show sharing options. Kindly check it and let me know if it is working.
Yes, sir.
Yes, fine. What about others?
Yes, sir. Done.
Done.
Sir, please once again.
Yeah, ma'am. One sec. So basically what you need to do is click on, just make sure every single time you're in the select mode, click this, share this lecture. And towards the end, you will see an option such as action. By default, it is none. Click on it and select this option, show sharing options.
Okay.
And by default, it is linked with topic. So just change it with sharing. अभी क्या होगा कि जब आप उसको share करोगे, जो आपने यहाँ पे content डाला था, if you remember, hello friend, I am sharing with you so and so, वो उसको लिख के आएगा. जैसे WhatsApp में कुछ शेयर करते हो तो वो लिख के आता है कि दिस वीडियो सो एंड सो उसका डिटेल्स आता है सेम थिंग फाइन
ओके ओके
ओके वन थिंग इज लेफ्ट आई गेस या ओके नाउ लास्ट वन इज लेफ्ट दिस लिस्ट ऐड इज लेफ्ट राइट सो लेट मी सर्च वन थिंग या व्हाट यू कैन डू इज अगेन क्लिक दिस प्लस लास्ट वन इज लेफ्ट व्हिच इज लिस्ट ऐड क्लिक ऑन दिस प्लस And search for something, I guess, toggle switch. Yeah. It is called switch. So click on switch and select it. I'm again repeating. Because as you can see, basically what I want is ki user ko ek radio button mil jaye. If the user clicks on that radio button, this particular lecture video should be added to the list of videos. मतलब basically suppose 10-12 videos अगर है मेरे पास और किसी एक video को मुझे as favorite save करना है, so I can simply click on this toggle button and it should be highlighted in my list करके. Fine. So this is totally optional. You can keep it or if you don't want it, you can simply delete it. Fine. Let me show it to you how you can add it. It's very simple. Click on this plus. Go to search and add this switch button. This automatically gets linked with list add. And by chance, if it is not automatically getting linked, you can simply click on this and select the last column of your Excel sheet, which is list add. Now you can see if I click on this, it is getting added to my list. Is it making sense? Kindly let me know. Similarly, you can change it to add to my list. Any confusion so far? Kindly let me know if it is done. We are almost reaching the end. Done? Any one of you is facing any issues? Kindly let me know.
No, sir.
Fine. Thank you. So similarly, I guess we missed one thing over here because we want this link to be clickable, right? If the user clicks on it, it should be pointed to the actual video. So again, go to action and open link. That's it. It's very simple. Simple drag and drop, click and point. That's it. So simply click on this link button, go to action and select open link. And the target is to be link only. So whenever I'm just showing in the play mode now, whenever I click on this, I should be redirected to the video link. Am I clear? Fine. So yes, this is how we can, thank you, sir. So this is how we can create the interface. So this particular interface is done. Right. So if you want to add something else, for example, in this case, you saw that instead of only lecture videos, I also have one more tab, short videos. So how to add it? Again, it's a repetitive process. What you can do is go back to your Excel sheet, simply add one more sheet. That's it. Give the columns, give the headings, what you want. Simply copy that, paste it. This is entirely on you. Just add your creativity and create such a thing. So now I have made some changes to the Excel sheet. What should I do now? Kindly let me know. I have made some changes to the Excel sheet.
Refresh option.
Correct. So you need to go back to the sheet over here and refresh it. Sometimes thoda zyada time lagta usko refresh karne mein, but aa jata hai. Yes, as you can see, there is one sheet 2 highlighted over here. Yes or no? समझा? So जितने भी आपको शीट्स चाहिए, you can keep on adding them as tabs. Now what you need to do is, ये जो main page है, उसको भी एक बार refresh कर दो. This main page also needs to be refreshed, and you should be able to see the new latest sheet that you have just now created over here. Side में आपको दिख रहा होगा, there are various options, sheet 1, sheet 2 करके. Over here, what you can do is, you can add a tab. जैसे इस case में, you can see there are tabs. Lecture videos and short videos, you can create a tab over here and it should be automatically highlighted. Sheet 2 jo aapne create kiya tha wahi same cheez maine copy paste kiya hai na. So what you can do is, I'm just going let me go slow over here because nahi to samjhega nahi. I will repeat this entire thing once again. Okay, so what I did is I went to this tab ka section, clicked on plus. ऑटोमेटिकली नीचे एक टैब बन के आ गया. इफ यू कैन सी दिस, सबके केस में हुआ ये. काइंडली लेट मी नो. आई एम रिपीटिंग द एंटायर प्रोसेस वंस अगेन. व्हाट आई डिड इज आई सिंपली कॉपीड द हेडर्स. जितना आपको डेटा चाहिए उसको कॉपी करो, पेस्ट इट ओवर हियर. आफ्टर दिस इज डन, गो बैक टू योर इंटरफेस एंड रिफ्रेश इट. दैट शुड डू इट.
डन सर.
थैंक यू मैम. व्हाट अबाउट अदर्स? काइंडली रिप्लाई. This is the last phase of the app. We are almost done.
Done, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Done, sir.
Thank you. Sampada ma'am, Vishaka ma'am.
Yes, sir. Done.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Done. Thanks a lot. John, sir? Yeah. Okay, so now what you need to do is you simply go back here and aisa kuch dikhna chahiye aapko. If it is visible, then it's fine. But just make sure right side mein aapko sheet 2 select karna hai. because second tab is now pointing to sheet 2 and not sheet 1. अगर ये नहीं दिख रहा है kindly refresh your page once. वहां पे sheet 2 दिखना चाहिए. Fine. And this is how it should look. Correct. Because there are no items yet. As you can see, the sheet 2 is only having the headers. It is not having any data in it. यहां तक सबका हुआ? We are almost reaching the end.
Yes. Fine. Yes.
Thank you, ma'am. So what you can do is, just for this demo purpose, you can copy the first row. सिर्फ पहला row copy कर लो और उधर जाके paste कर दो. If you see, मैंने list add नहीं डाला है because I wanted to be somewhat different. दोनों same हो जाएगा otherwise. Fine. Again, after doing the changes, always keep in mind that you have to go and refresh the page, otherwise वो highlight नहीं होगा. In my case, I have turned on auto refresh. वो पूछता है बीच-बीच में auto refresh on करना है कि नहीं. So you can keep it on. And let me know अगर ये display हो रहा है कि नहीं आपको. Fine, क्योंकि previously it was not showing anything because we were not having any data. Now we have at least one row of data, so it should be visible. Kindly acknowledge if it is
sir, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am. वो sheet 2 में जब ही copy कर रहे हैं ना तभी share में reference करके कुछ तो error आ रहा है.
मैम वही स्वप्नली मैम को भी शायद कुछ एरर आ रहा था. एक बार प्रॉपरली देखो, एक बार आ रहा है कि नहीं, एक बार ध्यान से देखो, क्योंकि मेरे केस में तो हो गया, कुछ इशू दिया नहीं. सेम शीट है, मैंने अभी बनाया.
हम्म, ओके, अभी ट्राई.
यस मैम. रेफरेंस का इशू कब होगा? अगर कुछ कॉलम्स का रेफरेंस का कुछ इशू है तो आएगा. एक बार वो कॉलम के नाम देख लो मैम, A2 A1 प्रॉपरली है कि नहीं. बाकी सबका हुआ? काइंडली लेट मी नो.
Yes sir.
Yes sir. Second tab is coming. खाली एक छोटा सा doubt है sir.
बोलो sir.
Doubt मतलब एक छोटा सा मैं शायद miss किया. How that video can be brought on the top? मेरे वाले में video is coming at the bottom.
हाँ sir, बहुत simple, एक second में दिखा देता हूँ.
Sorry, I guess I missed it.
No issue sir. Basically जब आप इसमें जाओगे, just make sure you are in the select mode.
Select mode.
और यहाँ पे आपको video by default नीचे add होता है. सिंपली ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप करना है उसको लेफ्ट से.
ओके 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 ओके, थैंक यू.
रीपोजिशन. यस सर, मोस्ट वेलकम सर. सो आई गेस द सेकंड टैब इज नाउ विजिबल, सो काइंडली लेट मी नो सो दैट आई कैन कम टू द कंक्लूजन. जस्ट एक लास्ट पार्ट बाकी है, आइकन्स एंड ऑल एंड एवरीथिंग एल्स इज डन. काइंडली एक्नॉलेज इफ इट इज डन. ओके कांचन मैम, हेजल मैम, हुआ
वो डाउट? यस यस यस, हो गया. मैंने कॉपी पेस्ट करते टाइम पे गड़बड़ किया था.
हां वही. थैंक यू मैम. ओके, सो द लास्ट स्टेप रिमेनिंग इज, इफ यू कैन सी एट द एंड, मैंने यहां पे आइकन्स डाले कुछ, तो सो यू कैन ऐड आइकन्स आल्सो. ऐसे करेंगे, गो टू ऑफ, एक सेकंड, लेट मी शो यू द आइकन्स. या व्हाट यू कैन डू इज, इफ यू क्लिक ऑन दिस टैब over here, there is an option called as tab icon. Just click on that and put any relevant icon you wish. For example, in my case, it was lectures. So aap kuch books ka option de sakte ho, kuch books, open book, close book, whatever you wish. You can add an icon like this. Let me select this. So as you can see, once you select that, at the end, aapka icon change ho jata hai. Kindly try it and let me know if it works out. Dono tab ka icon change kar dena. For both the tabs, and let me know if it is working.
Working, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Others also kindly let me know if it is working.
Done, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. So, last step remaining is, let me change this icon also. It is basically, okay, this will do for the time being. Fine. The only last thing remaining over here is you can add some design to the second tab also. So just keep in mind, jitne bhi aapke sheets honge, actually yahan pe, Excel sheet mein, utne aapke tabs bante jayenge. So if you want to highlight some particular tab, if you don't want to show any other tab, for example, jo second tab mera bana hai, uska naam hai new tab. So I can give a different name to it. For example, my short videos or whatever. You can give a relevant name to it so that the students or whatever, whoever is the target audience, they will be able to check this, right? Similarly, if you don't want to show this tab, you can simply go over here and hide it. So this tab will be hidden. It's really that simple. Without any piece of coding, we have designed a single utility app, right? The last thing left over here is just go to this third option. This is nothing but the finalizing part. From here, you can change the app color. From here, you can change the icon. This is my app, right? Go to app info. Give any icon you wish. I will keep it as it is. But if you want to change the icon, click on this change icon and you will get n number of options over here. You can even keep a WhatsApp smiley over here, right? So you can keep anything you wish as the icon of the app and then give it a name. For example, I'm keeping it as demo app. You can give a brief description to the app. And finally, only thing left is privacy. Because this is where it becomes important. If you are creating an app for the public, then it's fine. If you are creating an app where you are keeping it public, but you want the users to enter their email, then select this option, public with email, and allow sign in with Google account. Keeping this selected will give you the option of accepting the users even with their Google account. Otherwise, what will happen? If you don't select this, you will have to create user IDs and passwords and then share it with your students, and then they will be able to access it. So just make sure you click on this allow sign in with Google account. That's it. And the last step is sharing. Kindly let me know if you want me to repeat any step.
No, sir.
Okay, no, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot. So last step is click on sharing. Click on publish. It's almost done. Click on publish, publish app, and then you need to give a name to it. Let me give it a name as demo app 123. You can give any name. Oh, even that name is taken. So it has to be unique, right? So give any name. Yeah, this is fine. Copy it. So once you're done, copy this app, open a new tab, paste it, and it should be it. Once you're done, your app will look like this. Isn't it cool? Kindly let me know if you're done with this. It is the last step, and based on this, you need to provide your feedback. Once you're done, kindly let me know so that I can close the session.
सर रिपीट करो ना
कौन सा स्टेप मैम
ये लास्ट वाला
एक सेकंड
पब्लिश का
पब्लिश हां पब्लिश के बाद
हां ओके ओके हां एक सेकंड सो ये पेज दिख रहा है सबको ये पेज आया ना
यस यस कॉपी किया
सिंपली कॉपी किया एक न्यू टैब में जाके उसको पेस्ट कर दिया जस्ट टू ओपन इट एज अ न्यू टैब दैट्स इट न्यू टैब पे उसको पेस्ट करोगे तो आपका जो ऐप है वो दिख जाएगा डायरेक्टली इट शुड बी विजिबल आया क्या सबका काइंडली लेट मी नो
हाँ सर आ गए
ओके मैम सो वंस इट इज डन यू कैन काइंडली लॉग इन टू इट यूजिंग अ गूगल अकाउंट एंड चेक वेदर इट्स वर्किंग और नॉट थैंक्स अ लॉट मैम सो लेट मी क्विकली शेयर इन द फीडबैक लिंक इन बाय एक्चुअली आई हैव क्रिएटेड एन ऐप फॉर द फीडबैक ऑल्सो एज आई हैड शोन यू during the introduction. So let me share that app. Using this link, you can provide your feedback. I'm just putting the link in the chat box. Kindly go through it. You can put your feedback in that app, and whatever app you have created, kindly put that also for reference and for data.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. If you're having any queries, you can ask me. I hope this session was useful. So in what you can do is apart from Google Classroom, if you wish, you can even have your own app for your respective subjects, and then you can share it with your students. The students will be able to access it on the go. It would be even better and faster as compared to classrooms. Thanks a lot. So I hope this session was useful enough. If you have anything,
yes, sir. Thank you very much. Very nice.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Very nice session.
We'll surely implement this.
Yes, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Kindly provide your feedbacks. Yeah, kindly provide your feedback. Thank you so much.
For this, we have to make our own videos first.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Ma'am. You can even add the recorded lecture videos, na?
Yeah, yeah. Class that we can do. Right.
Yeah.
For yes, the subjects.
Yes. Thanks a lot. So kindly provide the feedback, and we can end the session here.